One, two, three.
It was a total whiteout. And then I don't know.
How do you do this? You do it the goniometric way. And what is the goniometric way? It's no more than isometrics, which maybe some of you have heard of and some of you haven't. Isometrics, goniometrics, we're going to call them from now on, are my way of doing isometric exercises. And what are they? It's working against an immovable object, such as a wall or a doorway here. Pushing against it, pulling against it, lifting against it. This is the goniometric way of exercising.
To all-star fishing.
Verne Gagne, former world champion and great sportsman.
Well, Gene, I fished all over the world, as these pictures will attest to, and I've never seen a greater business opportunity in one of the most fun sports in all the world, and that's fishing. I've got one of those Garcia graphites. I use that quite a bit. I've caught a lot of big ones all over, and then I'm going to catch a lot more.
With all of his personal and business successes, there was one part of the AWA that was special for Verne. It was what was known simply as the barn. It was where the AWA had its training camp. And over the years, it developed some of the biggest names in the history of the sport, some of which are still involved in the sport today. But make no mistake about it, it was considered hell on earth.
For Chris Taylor, it began last October at world champion Verne Gagne's wrestling farm near Chanhazen. About 20 hopefuls showed up during the first 2 weeks of training. Most of them couldn't take the calisthenics and dropped out.
50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 20.
235. Good, Chris.
Very good. That's only come down about 3 inches already.
Very good.
The one thing about wrestling that makes it colorful, it's made up of many different individuals. And this is an individual sport, a free enterprise. You can do your own thing, you can be yourself. It's no different than pro football or pro basketball or pro hockey or anything else. It has to be colorful, it has to be exciting.
It's not like amateur wrestling. You have to worry, do not worry about the point system, because there isn't any point system. Now, if a man is going to take you over and you're going to hurt yourself, he's going to try and bring you over and throw you over, then it's better to go with it and land your own way so you don't get hurt as bad.
Assisting Verne Gagne is Billy Robinson, who is himself one of pro wrestling's top performers.
Well, I've been fortunate enough to help coach many members of Olympic teams in collegiate wrestling and a few good professional wrestlers. And I believe that Chris could be as good as any professional wrestler that's ever been.
Don't put him down. I want to stay on your feet. Stay on your feet. Dive over the arm. Dive over. Watch. Real simple. Chris, now get up and dive over it. Good. Remember, falling is basic. You got to know how to fall. If you don't know how to fall, you're going to get hurt. And if you're hurt, you can't wrestle. And if you can't wrestle, you don't eat. It's that simple.
2.5 months of training with Verne Gagne is not easy. It was without a doubt the hardest training I've ever been through in my life. I mean, I've wrestled on the Olympic teams and a world team, and I've never been through a workout like that. I wish that I could have done it before the Olympics.
Come on, the guys get back in the ring. Come on, dig. Chris, hip lock off the rope.
It's December 3rd in the Minneapolis Armory. Chris Taylor's professional debut is just 5 days away.
Slam! Right, there he is! Okay, boom. Okay, cover him. All right, okay.
Now your pain tolerance has been built up on all you guys. I mean, you can take the slams better now than you could. You can take a flying mare better. The shock, you're learning how to fall. And the shock is going through your system. It's still the same shock you had the first time someone threw you down, but you're building up a tolerance to it. Chris, remember, once you felt yourself going again, I was freaking hurt yourself. You plowed it on your shoulder. Remember, if you're that far gone, get your body over so you land that flat way again. That's how you, that guy will not survive long if you don't learn to get over. Okay. You lay on him now. All right, now. The referee can hear that. There's 10,000 people out here screaming. You want to quit before your arm is broke. You'd better make some noise, brother.
You might be choking. Come on, let's go.
All the while, comes around to see it. Now, the people will see him doing it. They'll be screaming at the referee. But again, he can only call what he sees. So it'll depend on the referee to break that hold. And the guy's dragging around. Get out of it yourself. Fight out of it. So don't just walk out there, pick him up and lay him down. We want to see some action. We want to see what you can do.
Right into him.
I mean, when they announced my name and that, everybody cheered. It was really great, you know. But it's something that it could have went either way. It really could have. And I was very happy it went the right way.
Here he is, 450 pounds.
The matches are not made, and the style is not dictated to by the wrestler. It's what will the fans go and see. So the matchmaker has to be smart enough to match the proper guys together to catch the people's imagination. People love violence to a point. They love it rugged. In America especially, they want action. They want their money's worth. I would rather wrestle, prefer a clean bout all the time, and it won't draw money. So I have to wrestle guys like Rashawn, Nick Bockwink, Ray Stevens, superstar. That's what draws big money. And this is the reason why we had different personalities in wrestling.
It took the style of Nick Bockwinkel and his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, to finally snatch the title away from Verne. Bockwinkel would keep the title away by not offering Verne a rematch. But Verne was intent on getting it back, his belt. With no rematch in sight, Verne turned to tag team wrestling. While it was nothing new to him, since he had been a tag team champion 5 times in his career, a man who he partnered with was a bit of a surprise.
All right, gentlemen, Maurice Vachon, Verne Gagne, tonight the subject of a lot of conversation in the Twin Cities this past week. You're challenging Ventura and Adonis for the titles that you feel rightfully belong to you.
Well, I think everyone feels that way. You can't help but feel that way because we were stripped of them. They did not pin us. We did not submit. We did not give up in any kind of a hold. But yet they were handed those two belts on a big silver platter. And I told Stanley Blackburn, all right, but before I defend my title, please give us a chance back to regain these two belts if we can. And that's what they've done. So we're ready. We're really ready.
All right. Maurice Vachon on the same subject of challenging Ventura and Adonis for the World Tag Team Championship.
Well, it's obvious that the East-West connection and the champions tag team of the world are their false pretenses. And tonight, they're going to do everything they can to regain the championship tag team. But we're going to do everything that we can to take back what honestly belongs to us. You know, you people out there, your wrestling fans, you may not realize, but your moral support and your vocal support means a lot to Verne Gagne and I. And tonight, come out, and if you're behind us, that could make the difference.
All right, thank
what
you very much.
What he's saying is we're going to disconnect the connection.
Turkey Town 2, Verne Gagne's hometown. Well, let me tell you something, Verne Gagne and Mad Dog Vachon, I've received hope. You want to know why, Jack? Because last week I saw the world champion Pittsburgh Steelers come in here and do it to the Vikings right in their hometown.
Did you see what
happened? And now, with the East-West connection, the world champions are going to come right into your back door, Verne Gagne. We're coming right into your hometown, baby, and we're going to embarrass you, Jack, like you've never been embarrassed before. You are not getting these titles. These championships are ours, Verne Gagne and Vachon. And we'll go down all the way to keep them, baby.
all the way.
Adrian Adonis from the Big Apple.
First, let me take my sunnies off because my beautiful brown eyes in front of all the living people in living color and living TV land. I'd like to say this. I'd like to clarify one thing and make myself perfectly clear that we are the champions. Yes, we are. Nobody handed to us on a silver platter. Mad Dog Vachon, you need the morale, right, Daddy? We don't need any morale for anybody. This is our morale. Right. The World Tag Team Belt, Jack, and you're not getting them.
Garnia is cautioning. Mad Dog, be careful. Be careful. Watch it, he said. A cover. One. It's a body breaker, back breaker, cover, Donis in, holds him, oh, and in comes Gagne.